I don't know if you, Rich, if you've been paying attention. They got that Kawhi and Don thing going up there.
He could eat for free.
He could eat it, and it's on every restaurant. I've been in Toronto for the last probably month. That Kawhi and Don thing is on pretty much every single restaurant. And then when I was up there last week, somebody offered him like a $3 million penthouse.
Yes, right, yeah, right.
So I'm thinking like, hey, if I can eat everywhere for free.
And live.
Because you know what's interesting about this free agent thing?
Mm-hmm.
There's only two players that's going to make your team better. Kawhi Leonard and Kevin Durant. Those were the only two players. Those other guys are good little players. But if you get one of those other guys, it don't mean anything. So I think what's going to be fascinating this whole summer is, wait, if we don't get Kawhi or KD, we ain't going to be a lot better. We're just going to be paying some guys who are good players. We're going to be really stuck in the same boat. We ain't going to be contenders. So that's the thing. That with the injury to KD, depending on what he does, and now he probably out for next year too. But if you don't get at least two of these guys, and especially Kawhi and KD, which now since he's hurt, that changes that dynamic, your team ain't going to be a lot better. I mean, you might win a couple more games, but you ain't going to be a contender.
So if Philly had a Chowine and Dine, would you have ever left Philadelphia, Charles?
Listen, some of them guys they had playing me, I thought about starving. I would have starved to death and played with some of them guys they had me playing with.
Oh, come on.
Listen, Philly's the only organization in the world. We had the number one pick in the draft. And we all went out celebrating the night before because I say, I know, I cannot wait to play with Brad Daugherty. There's good times ahead for Chuck. I am good. I'm in my prime. I think I was in my third or fourth year when I was just becoming a star. I'm like, I got Brad Daugherty for the next 10 years. We go out celebrating. I get a phone call at 6 o'clock in the morning from the late, great Phil Jackson, St. Charles. I'm like, Phil, it's a little early, don't you think? He says, well, I want to talk to you about the trade. He says, I said, what trade? He said, the Sixers traded the number one pick in the draft. I says, Phil, the 76ers are not that stupid. They're not total morons. Me and Brad Daugherty together for the next 10 years. I like our chances. And they're like, no, they traded it. I said, Phil, let me call you back in an hour. Let me go take a shower and sober up. I called Phil back an hour later. He says, that's Phil, are you serious? He said, yeah. And he said, not only that, they traded Moses to Washington because Moses was my mentor. He made me lose 50 pounds. I thought he would have been great for Brad Daugherty. He ended up playing like another 5 or 6 years. He would have been a great backup. And they traded him to D.C. for Jeff Rulin, who I never played with because he was hurt. And then they traded, obviously, Brad, who had a hell of a career, to Cleveland. And I got Roy Henson, who's a nice guy and a friend of mine, but he was no Brad Daugherty. And I just toiled the next 5 or 6 years like a loser. And so, no, I would have starved to death to get the hell out of Philly.
Oh, you're the best, Charles.
For more of The Rich Eisen Show, tune to Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV for free on BR Live or download The Rich Eisen Show app.